I'm Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. When guitar players start to study scales, one of the most common mistakes that they'll make is they'll generally focus on the pentatonic patterns for too long, sometimes even completely bypassing the foundation of all musical scales entirely. And if you haven't guessed, the scale I'm referring to is the major scale. So today, I've got one of my personal favorite major scale shapes to show you, and by the end of this video, you're going to be using it to make some beautiful music. After this, join me for the second half of the lesson over on my Patreon page, where I've got a second scale shape for you to check out, along with a new tonality and a beautiful sounding smooth jazz melody that applies everything over a very cool group of chords that you can download as an MP3 jam track. But first, before we get started, a quick word about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. This example of my favorite major scale pattern is going to be shown to you today in the key of C major. It runs from between the fifth string all the way up to first, and it's going to cover the fingerboard from around second position all the way up to 13th fret. So we're going to get started by looking at the note layout of this scale that I have for you. And we're going to go across the fretboard with that, and I'm going to show you a practice routine later, and then we'll talk about, you know, how to take it forward into creating melody and soloing and that stuff. But the scale itself, the way it's looked at, is it's going to be set up in two chunks. One of them is going to be just a standard scale layout. If you're studying my advanced guitar program over at creativeguitarstudio.com, you're going to find this one in the advanced section under major scale pattern number 2. And it's a very straightforward shape, really easy to play, just set up right, you know, off of fifth string to third string in position. And then what we're going to do is look at the remainder of the scale layout as its own kind of lateral, like more horizontally laid out, you know, chunk of notes. You can tell there, you know, can be set up in a lot of ways for some really cool two-note chord frames. You know, can be, you know, pretty cool for some sounds there where you're, you know, doing some nice two-note work, or, you know, just a lot of more lateral stuff. So those are the two, you know, frameworks that we're building off of. And, you know, in the beginning, it might be kind of like really tough to be able to memorize all those in one go. So I do have a C major scale practice routine that uses this entire layout of all these tones on the neck. And I'm just going to go through it here with you. Let me play it at first, and then we'll kind of break it down step by step. It goes like this. So what we're doing, starting in that first framework there, that's in second position going through that whole scale. But when we get to the third string, we're sliding forward and we're getting that second fret sliding to fourth, then a fifth fret note with middle finger, and then sliding upward to go from 7 to 9 with the small finger. Then on second string, we're gonna go 6 to 8, sliding with index finger. We'll next grab the 10th fret with the third finger, and then on first string, slide forward 7 to 8 with index. And then the third finger can be used to slide from 10 to 12, and then get the remainder of the scale laid out in 10th position, just, you know, going down from that high F, 13, 12, 10 on first string, and then just the C and the B to wrap things up there on the second string. So it turns out to be a pretty easy routine to practice, and then this will help you memorize the whole layout of the shape. All right, so that's the scale. That's a practice routine for you so you can memorize it. We're gonna just next come along with a nice scale application melody. I'm gonna perform that for you right now, and then we'll dig into it so you can learn it yourself. Thank you. Okay, you can tell it's a pretty sweet melody. It's got a real bounce to it, too. And I think that's something that's very common in all the sounds of major. It's very happy. It's pleasant, uplifting a lot of times. I mean, can you have a song in major that's sad? Of course you can. You could make it that way. But in this case, I wanted to have a pretty bouncy, happy sounding riff here in C major. And all the chords are pretty straightforward. I'm just using a C major chord into an F chord, bringing around an A minor into the G chord, and that's the four bar progression with those four chords. But let's get to really the cool part about all this is just the application of this unique major scale pattern. Happens to be one of my favorite pattern layouts on the neck, but let's just get into this and break it down on how this melody works. We're starting off in the third string area with the fifth and fourth frets, and then sliding up to seven. Then we're gonna have a five on second string, bringing us back to the C note on third string. We're gonna jump up in the scale shape that's on the upper three strings now and get the eight and seven, and then 10 and eight going between first string to second string, eight, seven, 10, eight. Then we're gonna be more or less in sixth position, playing six into the nine. That's a nice in position reach with the small finger to keep you all together there in your four fret span. And then what we're gonna do is play an eighth fret note with a grace note slide that takes us into the 10th fret. And then we're gonna play on the top string there, eight, 10, eight. All right, so that's our first two measures. Okay, and then from there into the A minor chord, we're gonna grab a 10th fret on the second string, play that on second string there, and then get into the first string doing a pull off 12 to 10. And then we're gonna grab a 13th fret note, that's the C note of course, down to the 12th, which is B, back to the C on 13, and then into the 10th fret A. Great note to hit because we happen to be on an A minor chord, so that sounds really nice. And then into that final measure on the G major chord, we're gonna be grabbing into an eighth fret second string G, pedaling off a ninth fret E note real quick, but back to the G just as fast. Just like that. Slide forward, 10th fret, 12th fret, grace note slide, down to 10 again. And then in the eighth fret there, grabbing that G root, and we're gonna pedal back here off seven, and then come back around again to that G. So that's kind of a cool, breakdown of notes because the D is the perfect fifth of our G chord. So it kind of really ties in strong to the sound of that G there. So it's kind of a nice, ending bit. All right, so that's that third and fourth measures. And that's the whole idea of that melody. Now, my suggestion is you can learn this, or you could just use the scale, try and come up with some of your favorite jams. Remember too, this jam track is part of your Patreon download. I do hope you join me next for the part two of this video on Patreon. You can find us over there at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you need help though with all your theory, breakdowns about this kind of stuff, if you want to check out the courses that I have over on my website, it will really help you tons with understanding all this information. Just go to creativeguitarstudio.com. Click on the courses button and then go in there and check out all the great courses that we have. You can sign up for a free membership, no obligation. Go in, check it all out and just kind of peruse everything and see what's, going on the site. There's a ton of free stuff for free members. I also have a quick licks program. You're going to love that. And, at some point you can always sign up for a membership, dig into the core curriculum. I've got my introductory, intermediate, advanced there. You're going to love that stuff too. But I'm going to wrap this video up now here on YouTube. And like I said, I do hope you will join me next over on Patreon. Once again, the address over there is patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus part two video, I've got a second minor scale for you to check out, along with the new tonality and a beautiful sounding smooth jazz melody that applies everything over a cool group of chords that you can download as an MP3 jam track. The part two video is going to be a lot of fun. I do hope you'll join me on Patreon. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.